It's crazy. I've never understood that some people think that science is as boring as watching paint dry. Even if scientists literally watched paint dry, it would probably be part of some fascinating experiment aimed at the betterment of all humanity, or at least the betterment of some paint. There are a lot of scientific endeavors that take an immense amount of time, but produce the most amazing results, and here are some of the oddest among them. Number 1. Sunspot Observation. Yeah, this is the kind of long-winded science that won't ever be replaced, because we will be observing and studying our sun for as long as it's here with us. And it's been captivating curious minds for as long as it's been here. One of the most remarkable features of the sun is the appearance of huge, dark, and extremely magnetic spots on its surface. They can even be larger than the entire Earth. While Western observers believe the idea of the Greek philosopher Aristotle that the sun is perfect, their Chinese colleagues were not so sure about that. Their first note about sunspots was quite poetic. It reads, "The sun was yellow at its rising, and a black vapor as large as a coin was observed at its center, and dates to 28 BCE. Since that ancient time, astronomers have discovered that sunspots have a direct impact on the Earth's climate. For example, there was a period called Medieval Maximum, from 1100 to 1250, when a lot of sunspots were observed, and which coincides with a period of warmer climate called the Medieval Warm Period. Later, the period from 1645 to 1715, known as Little Ice Age, for obvious reasons, corresponded with the Maunder Minimum Period on the Sun, in which almost no sunspots were observed. Number 2. Alarm bell that just won't stop. Let's depart from abstract and distant things and talk about something we all know well, probably too well. Alarms. Those things that startle us in the morning, tearing us away from sweet dreams. And it seems like scientists like their humor dry and bitter, because the only thing that has kept its charge for 179 years now is not my phone. It's an electric bell like those on an alarm clock. It's been ringing since 1840. Uh-oh, somebody's going to be late. And it's placed right in the foyer of Clarendon Laboratory at the University of Oxford. You may think, how do sciences even work if there's always ringing? But the bell is closed behind two layers of soundproof glass. What keeps it ringing is a clapper between two bells that still moves from one to another. Those bells are attached to batteries called dry piles. The exact composition of these batteries is unknown to this day, but the fact remains, the bell still rings. Number 3. Almost Perpetual Clock. If someone decides one day to attach the endless bell to these clocks, that would be the cruelest invention in the history of cruelty. But fortunately, this clock device stands in the University of Otago in New Zealand. It hasn't been wound since it was made in 1864 by Arthur Beverley, and has almost never stopped to this day. Occasionally, the mechanism of Beverley clock needs cleaning and repair, but it works perfectly without being wound. This is achieved through the clever usage of an airtight box that's highly sensitive to shifts in temperature and atmospheric pressure. Depending on the daily temperature variation, this airtight box expands and shrinks. When it expands, it pushes with enough force to lift the weight that keeps the clock mechanism running. Does that mean that Beverley clock is a perpetual motion device that will run forever? Not really, because it still needs external influence in the form of temperature shifts. But it doesn't need any human involvement except occasional maintenance. Number 4. Elusive Pitch Drops. What the heck is that, you ask? This scientific study is the winner of the prize for the most laughable scientific achievements and the holder of the world record as the longest continuously running laboratory experiment. It took 3 years to even prepare for this experiment, but its appearance seems kind of underwhelming at first. It's just a funnel that was filled in 1927 with a highly dense pitch known to us as tar or asphalt. When the pitch settled down in 1930, its bottom was opened by Professor Thomas Parnell. This experiment shows that pitch is not a solid material, but a very thick fluid. The idea is that pitch, like any fluid, will form drops over time, and those drops will eventually fall. But no one saw it happening. The reason is not scientific inaccuracy, of course. The pitch is a liquid material, but it flows 30 billion times slower than water, for example. It took, on average, 8 years for the first 7 drops to fall. Thanks to the conditioning system cooling down the air, the next 2 drops almost doubled on that time. No matter how long it takes, they always seem to fall in the exact moment when no one is around, like science itself is laughing at this experiment. Even when it was first monitored with a video camera, something went wrong with it, and the moment of the drop separation from the funnel was erased. Now is the first time capturing the fall of a drop is almost completely inevitable. The funnel is streamed via webcam 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. How exciting, hmm? People around the internet furiously argue about when the next drop will fall down, which proves that even the most boring thing ever can be made fascinating with science. Number 5. 500 years for one experiment. Oh boy. Some experiments are imagined with the mindset that human life is just too short to answer some of the questions people might ask today. One such question appeared in the bright mind of Charles Cockle from the University of Edinburgh. Once, he forgot about a Petri dish with lots of bacteria in it. Forgot for 10 years. More than enough time for the bacteria to dry up. I would just pretend it's not mine and throw it away in shame, but that's probably why I'm not a scientist. Charles acted much differently. He tried to revive the bacteria after all this time and succeeded. Since then, he's been wondering, how long can dried bacteria survive? In 2014, his ambitious experiment began. All he needed was 2 wooden boxes with sealed glass vials that contained bacteria inside. And most importantly, instruction for future scientists, because in 2514, Charles probably won't be around to open the last vials and revive the bacteria himself. Probably. Once in every 25 years, scientists must open some of the vials, pour water on the bacteria, and try to make them reproduce. Oh, and copy the instructions on whatever format will be used in the future. 500 years from now, people may not even know what a USB drive is. Number 6. More than 66,000 generations in Petri dishes. Another example of microbiologists' impressive patience, perseverance, and persistence is an experiment that's been run by an American evolutionary biologist, Richard Lenski, since 1988. It may seem like it's not that long, but only in human years. In 2016, 12 populations of bacteria named E.coli reached the point of 66,000 generations. For human species, that would be a time span of a bit under 2 million years. All these generations of E.coli are needed to track little evolutionary changes in them and to watch the evolution itself in miniature. The most interesting part of this ongoing observation is the failure of the prediction that species must reach their peak fitness for maximum adaptation to the environment. According to common knowledge in biology, that would have already happened with the bacteria used in the experiment. But they keep changing more and more. That means that evolution never stops, and Mother Nature always has room for improvement. For example, somewhere between 31,000 and 31,500 E. coli developed an ability to feed on 2 food sources besides the one that was already digestible for them. Wow. The best part about this experiment is that it's not going to end anytime soon, and we can learn so much from it. This is how even simple and boring beginnings can lead to great discoveries or inventions. Have you ever felt like science wakes up your imagination and makes your mind rush forward to something you really want to know? Tell us your story in the comment section. And don't forget to leave this video a like, share it with your friends, and click subscribe to always stay on the bright side of life.